Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Ferndale High School Student Enterprise Theater production of The Face on the Barroom Floor. Today's show is a melodrama, which puts it in the same classification as the Dudley Do Right cartoons and the silent films of the 1920s. Obviously, this will not be like most plays you've seen. For example, during the show, when our villain enters, you will hear his theme. You will usually... And our signs will appear asking you to boo him. When our hero enters, you will hear his theme. And we ask that you cheer him. Whenever our heroine, Miss Madeleine Mockingbird, enters, you will hear her theme. We ask that you follow the prompts given in these signs whenever they occur, as it will not only enhance your entertainment, but ours as well. And so, ladies and gentlemen, we give you The Face on the Barroom Floor.
I won't stop you. tell the truth, business ain't been what it used to be. The gold in them there hills is running dry, and I need every penny I can get.
What room number?
Take your pick. The keys are in the locks.
I must rest. I'm not well.
It's a bum way to get lit. hear me? Hattie Bessie? How do you hear me? Howdy, Chick.
Howdy, Chick.
Howdy, Chick. Six alive, one howdy apiece ought to be enough.
You're all frazzled. Get a hold of yourself.
Nobody ever said he's brave.
It's that society woman and her daughter I got riding with me. They don't do nothing but complain. And that little girl, she just talks and talks and talks. Boy, the last time I saw a mouth like that, it had a fish hook in it.
You need something to calm your nerves is what it is.
Sounds like a good idea, Annie.
Name your poison.
Oh, I wish she hadn't said that. I'll have a Singapore sling, Annie.
A what?
A Singapore sling. Make it a Singapore sling, Annie.
Make it yourself. American drinks in here.
Well, in that case, I'll have a sarsaparilla. He in a dirty glass. I wouldn't want him to think I'm going high.
Any passengers?
See for yourself.
Annie?
Yeah?
How come this here sarsaparilla tastes like kerosene?
Only the whiskey ought to taste like kerosene. The sarsaparilla's supposed to taste like tree bark.
Well, it don't. Whoever heard of drinking tree bark?
It plays tricks.
I thought I heard something.
Like what?
Oh.
Like that.
Something to drink or I'll perish.
Something to drink or I'll perish. That's what the voice said.
Wonder who it can be.
Some poor soul lost in the snow, I reckon. It's that time of year.
Oh.
Sure is taking his time getting here.
It's the wind, I tell you. What we're hearing is a mirage.
Mirage? What a baboon.
I'm coming. Closer. Almost there. Soon be with you.
Don't hurry on our account.
Where's he coming from? Mexico City?
Here, hey, me!
He came in the back way.
That ain't no mirage.
Something to drink or I perish.
You already said that.
Oh, fate is cruel.
Fate? Who?
Get away from him, little Gloria. He looks rabid.
Oh, he don't look like a rabbit to me. It looks like he's got gold fever.
Look him shake.
I'm not shaking from gold fever. I'm shaking from common, ordinary fever.
I probably have pneumonia, influenza, and a little frostbite.
I've been traveling for days and days in blinding snow and freezing temperatures.
You better give him a drink, Annie.
Right! What does it be?
Iced tea if you have it.
What are you all staring at? Haven't you ever seen a man at the end of his rope before? I'm finished, done for, through. I have nothing to live for.
Don't you want your iced tea?
I know what you're all thinking. From out of the storm appears a wretch. And I am that wretch. Wretch.
That's nice. Maybe I ought to go get the sheriff. You know what to do.
No. No, don't get the sheriff. He can't do anything. I'm no criminal.
Maybe getting the sheriff ain't such a good idea after all.
Why not?
He's vacationing in Utah.
Drink it slowly, mister. You'll feel better.
No lemon?
Not till summer. Where did it come from, Mother?
You saw. The wind blowed it in.
Wonder what he wants.
He's filthy looking.
Yeah, he is. Looks like he's found a new use for torn, dirty old clothes.
He wears them.
Go on, laugh. Ridicule. I'm used to it.
You got any money?
I'm out of funds. Though once my pockets sang the melody of silver dollars caressing one another.
Why, he's got the voice of a poet. We don't get many poets in Central City.
What's a poet?
Well, a poet is a kind of a writer who expresses himself in verse.
You don't remember me, do you? Your name's Annie Quackenbush. And your chick dog temper. And you're Drifty Rhodes.
My name's Dusty Rhodes, not Drifty.
And you're Herbie Rainwater.
Well, what do you know?
He just told you.
He seems to know all of you well enough.
I was once a man with muscle, frame, and health.
You could have fooled me.
Wait a minute. I think I know him.
Who is he?
Ain't you that painter fellow that went by the name of Jack Goodhart?
Jack Goodhart!
I still go by the name of Jack Goodhart. Jack Toulouse Goodhart. I am still that man, or rather, the shell of that man. Behold the wreckage.
Jack Toulouse Goodhart?
The same.
Rubbish. Mr. Jack Toulouse Goodhart is well known in Denver society. You're nothing like him. Nothing at all.
You sound mighty sure of yourself.
I certainly would recognize Mr. Goodhart. Why, he even once painted a portrait of little Gloria. You remember, dear, don't you?
Yes, but I didn't like it. My dress was too red, my eyes were too blue, and my skin was too pale.
No, shut up.
Well, I'm sticking to my guns. You ain't wearing any.
Well, I say this here bozo is Goodhart.
Maybe you're right. Why, look at his fingers. He's got paint all over him.
See there, that proof.
And if I remember rightly, you was in love with sweet Maddie Lane Mockingbird when she worked here.
I have never been out of love with sweet Maddie Lane Mockingbird.
Last time Herbie and me saw you, it was in Denver when you was a gentleman.
A gentleman? This ruffian, this is vagrant, this tramp.
Chick Dog Temper speaks the truth. I was once a gentleman.
What happened, Jack?
It's a really tragic story. Are you sure you want to hear it?
I love a story.
I like to hear a good story on account of I can't read.
I ain't driving the stage in that storm.
Could he be speaking the truth? I wonder.
Maybe he is too loose. Don't be shy, Jack.
We got time to hear your story.
Well.
Come on, Jack. Tell us how you came from being a gent to being a bum.
A dirty one at that.
So be it. But be forewarned. What I have to tell you will be no page torn from the Arabian Nights. But my voice is cracked. My throat worn out. My lungs going fast. I'll set the record straight. I loved sweet Maddie Lane Mockingbird. I loved being with her here in Central City, Colorado, the United States of America. I was semi-successful. I was happy until that fateful day when he came into this very place, this very room, and stole my dreams of bliss and harmony.
Who was that, Jack?
Who, you ask?
Yes, who?
The architect of my misery.
Who?
The bane of my existence. That rogue, that skunk in human form, that villain. That oily scoundrel, that conniving, no good reprobate. That smiling but thoroughly bad person. Roderick Rodent.
Roderick Rodent!
Thank you.
almost as good as you play cards.
Thanks, boys. Cards pay better.
Let's play a hand.
Why not?
What'll we play?
I like fish.
I like hearts.
Poker.
Okay by me.
Me too.
Deal.
You sure do know how to play cards, Bella.
Yeah, Bella. Where'd you learn?
Who taught you?
Well, some folks are born with a silver spoon in their mouth. I was born with a poker chip in mine.
It's him.
you in the theater, hasn't he?
Yes, yes. But how did you know?
And I'll bet you had money when you first met him, too.
That also is true.
And have you been in the theater?
Yes, the balcony.
He's still playing that old tune.
Fatima! Fatima, where are you?
That is Roderick Roden now.
Enter Roderick Roden. My luggage.
Yes.
And don't drop that jar of mustache wax. It's important. Champagne, your best.
Zounds, is this place deserted?
No.
Park, do I hear a voice?
Bella Yukon, you here?
At last. I knew our paths would cross again. After all these years, you promised to make me a big star. You promised to make me a headliner. Then you took my money and you ran.
Nonsense. I've been working in your interest night and day. Didn't you get my postcard?
You found another foolish girl with money and you promised her what you promised me. You won't get away with it. I'll stop you. I'll destroy you.
You jest!
Wait and see, you bug.
Enough!
No female creature speaks to Roderick Rodent in that fashion.
You know my temper.
You know mine.
I suppose this is your idea of a civilized conversation?
Can't we be friends?
Don't try and trick me. You're as slick as an oil lamp, and don't I know it?
You never really understood me.
I thought when I met you, my life would change for the better. I was sick of being a gambling lady, weary of cheating the bumpkins and clods I skinned at cards.
When it comes to cheating at cards, you're a genius. I've always admired the criminal mind.
I want to be a star.
An admirable ambition. I applaud it.
Bravo, Bella.
I believed you when I handed over my money. You were supposed to arrange a tour from town to town, opera house to opera house. Tonight, alive, Bella Yukon on stage, sold out.
No refunds.
You took the money and ran. I swore I'd get even, and I shall. Give me my money!
I'd be only glad to, Bella. However, at the moment, I happen to be shy of funds.
That Fatima has money, doesn't she?
Only a few dollars left, and when that's gone, she's finished.
She's a pretty young thing, but she has the brain of a butterfly. I could do better.
I thought for a while I might pass her off as Fatima, the dancing desert ditch. But I've seen camels who can walk better than she can dance. Is it possible for a girl to have a fiancé backwards?
Give me my money!
Talk of finances vulgar. Dine with me tonight and I'm sure we can dissolve this matter.
Liar!
You do mean injustice.
It's all a misunderstatement.
You can't weave your web around me, you spider.
First a bug, and now a spider? Tisk tisk.
I'm not the girl you played for fool. I'm older now.
I noticed.
Wiser too. I'm out for everything I can get these days, including revenge. My money, or I'll see you behind bars.
She means it.
And don't try and run off and leave town. I've got friends. If I tell them, they'll use your head for a doorstop.
Curses! I come to Central City for new victims, and I find an old one.
I will give you exactly 1 hour.
How do you do, sir? Are you the manager?
I'm a theatrical manager, if that's what you mean. My card.
Exchange this ticket at the bar for one free taco.
You're reading the wrong side.
Well, so I am. Roderick Roden, theatrical producer. And what, sir, do you produce?
Profit. For myself.
I'm Judge Fleesum of Denver.
Good to meet you, Judge. I always say if you don't know a good lawyer, it pays to know a good judge.
Good thinking, Mr. Rodent.
So, is it business or pleasure that brings you here to Central City?
Business.
What a shame. May I offer you a libation?
Thank you, but I never indulge.
A judge who doesn't indulge? What is this world coming to?
I will, though, sit. The trip from Denver was fatiguing.
Hurry along with the luggage, Fatima.
And don't drop
anything.
You will put me on the stage, Master?
Would I lie? Now move it. Hurry up, you can't get out of the plane until you get this stuff off stage. So. I suppose it's mining business that brings you here to Central City.
Not at all, Mr. Vermin.
Rodent.
I hold here the last will and testament of a one Bonaparte B. Boogaloo.
Boogaloo? How do you spell it?
Wrong every time.
And who was this Bonaparte B. Boogaloo?
A ramshackle miner. He's left a sizable fortune to an unsuspecting chambermaid here at the teller house.
Fortune? A sizable fortune.
You let them put you in the attic. All show people have to pay in advance. Cash. No cough syrup.
Are you by any chance the female known as Sweet Madeleine Mockingbird?
No, I'm her employer, Sour Annie Quackenbush.
I'm Judge Fleesum of Denver. I have important news for Miss Mockingbird. Might I have a word with her?
Why not?
A would-be songstress? About to inherit a fortune? I smell opportunity knocking.
You scream, Danny?
Yeah.
He wants to talk to you. Says he's a judge. I've never spoken with a judge before. Well, this is your big chance. In honor, sir.
Gad, she's easy on the eyes.
I have wonderful news for you.
Oh?
Do you recall an old miner by the name of Bonaparte B. Boogaloo?
Boogaloo?
Boogaloo.
Boogaloo? I don't think so.
Well, Boogaloo remembers you, or rather, remembered you. Said whenever he was feeling low and depressed with his lot in life, he'd come here and watch you scrub and mop. The sight of you cheered and warmed him. It was this vision that inspired him to travel to Arizona and strike it rich in the town of Bisbee. He had no friends, no heirs, and no companions. Consequently, he has left his entire fortune to you.
Oh, joy! I wish I could remember him. Now that I'm rich, I won't be needing those anymore. Beginner's luck!
If I may be of any further assistance, don't hesitate to contact me. You'll receive your sizable fortune in due course. I leave on the morning stage. I trust, madam, you have a room I might engage for the night.
Best in the house, Judge. I've set you up with the bridal suite. It's got a fur rug on the floor and a Ziploc tub. Follow me.
I'm obliged.
Do excuse me.
I have no wish to intrude on your composition.
Whatever that means.
But a moment ago, I heard the most enchanting melody drifting down through the upper stories. I wonder, can you tell me to whom that angelic voice belongs?
Did the voice sound like this?
It was you. You are the possessor of that magical voice.
You like music, sir?
Like it? I adore it. Especially when it comes with money attached. My card.
Exchange this ticket at the bar for one free...
Allow me.
Oh. Roderick Rodent, theatrical producer.
I have that honor. Might I inquire of your name? Or would you think me boorish?
Madeline. Madeline Mockingbird. Sometimes I'm also called Sweet Madeline Mockingbird.
Charming. Let me be straight with you. Your voice is raw. I mean rare. But the world deserves to hear it. I will guide you. I will put you on the stage.
The stage? You mean with curtains and footlights and music and pretty costumes?
Precisely.
I've always dreamed of being on the stage. But it's always been just that, Mr. Rat, a dream.
Well, I happen to be in the business of making dreams come true. You might say that I'm a dream merchant. If you will allow me, sweet Maddie Lane, I'll take you away from all of this and put you on the stage.
Oh, if only I could.
There's a problem?
The boy I plan to marry, Jack Toulouse Goodhart.
What about him?
He would never approve of me going on the stage.
Then we must be rid of him. The sooner, the better.
That's Jack now. I know his voice anywhere.
Imagine that.
Guess what, Jack?
What?
An old miner, a man I don't even remember, died and left me his fortune. I'm rich!
That's nice. But wait till you see what I have here. Well, what do you think?
What is it?
What is it?
She asked you first.
Why, it's you, sweet Maddie Lane, as I see you.
Your eyes are getting a bit weak, Jack. Maybe you should see an octopus.
This is one time when they shouldn't hang the picture. They should hang the artist.
Jack, this is Mr. Roderick Roach.
Rodent!
He's a theatrical producer. Mr. Roach.
Rodent!
This is the boy I plan to marry.
Jack Toulouse Goodhart.
Not Roach, Miss Mockingbird. Rodent. I've been talking to your fiancé about some plans I have to put her on the stage. I trust you have no objections.
My future wife on the stage?
No, sir.
I could never allow that.
Nay.
Sounds like he's a little hoarse. It over, perhaps? If you'll excuse me, I shall retire to my room and refresh myself.
There's something about that man I don't like, Maddie Lane. He looks dishonest. Besides, kids, you can't trust show folk. They're all glitter and false promise. Forget the stage. Forget your newfound wealth. When two such as we are in love, all worldly considerations are meaningless.
What a chicken head!
I'm semi-successful now, Maddie Lane. People are buying my pictures. Name the date. My heart is thumping with the music of love. Hear it? Thump, thump, thump.
You'll love me forever, Jack.
I swear it.
Always be true.
Always.
You'll never love another girl.
Never.
Never even kiss another girl?
Perish the thought.
Then we can be married right away. There's a judge upstairs.
Hey, Maddie Lane.
Howdy, boys.
We're looking for a dude what calls himself Roderick Roden. Fellow Yukon wants us to keep an eye on him.
Upstairs in the attic.
Oh, Jack, there's some folks outside looking at your pictures. You better get on out there unless you want to miss a sale.
Now listen to me, Maddie Lane. First, we'll sell a picture. Then, we'll get married. You see how ambitious yet practical I am.
Oh, Jack. Someday they'll put up a statue of you.
Statue? He's halfway there already. His head's full of cement. Traitor! You sent some goons after me!
I told you I'd friends.
Listen to me, Bella. A plum has dropped into my lap.
A plum by the name of Sweet Maddie Lane Mockingbird?
She fancies herself a songstress.
She sounds like a cat in boiling water.
Ah,
but a rich cat.
What are you talking about?
Have you ever heard of an old miner by the name of Bonaparte B. Boogaloo?
Boogaloo? How do you spell it?
Never mind that.
Bonaparte B. Boogaloo. A crazy old geezer. Used to live and work around here in Central City. Why?
He died. A rich geezer. And he left all his money to Sweet Maddie Lane.
What?
Fortunately, the silly girl harbors a secret desire. A stage career?
I think I understand.
I thought you would. With your help, Bella, you'll get your money back, and I'll become rich.
Why do you want my help?
The city girl plans to be married soon. That mustn't happen.
Means Jack Toulouse, Goodheart.
The same. You must get that painter out of the picture. Painter out of the picture.
That's a really bad joke, Rhodey.
Maybe that's why nobody's laughing.
Can you see him?
I know they're out there. I can hear them breathing.
You couldn't tell the truth without lying. You were trying to trick me again.
You want your money back, don't you?
Yes.
Then trust me.
You see how the money rolls in, Sweet Maddie Lane? You're marrying a painter who is going on to fame and fortune.
Destroy him, Bella. It's only Bella you can destroy a man.
Leave it to me.
A word with you, Miss Mockingbird? In private?
About your stage career.
Hey, wait a minute.
You're that painter fellow that everybody's talking about. How come you've never painted a picture of me?
You never asked.
Well, you know, most people say I'm picturesque.
Well, you're very beautiful, Miss Yukon.
Buy me a drink.
I'm afraid I don't drink.
Never?
I promised my mother.
Well, you wouldn't let me drink alone now, would you? That would be impolite.
I would never be impolite, Miss Yukon.
Call me Bella.
Bella?
What'll it be?
Carrot juice, please.
I'll give him your carrot juice. 200 proof carrot juice.
Say,
Do you know that man talking to Sweet Maddie Lane?
Oh, forget about him. Here comes your carriages.
Thank you, Monsieur. Bella.
As sailors say, down the hatchway.
Down the hatchway.
Wow! That sure don't taste like carrot juice.
Have another?
Don't mind if I do.
He's got a taste for the stuff. This'll be easier than I thought.
Tasting carrot juice I ever had.
You know, you're one handsome young man, Jack Goodhart.
Oh, think so?
No, so kiss me.
Huh?
I said, kiss me.
Oh, no, I couldn't. It wouldn't be fair to Sweet Maddie Lane. I'm engaged.
What if you don't kiss me? You hurt my
Well, I'm glad you find this so amusing, mister. What would you do in my position? Well, all right. But you'll have to give me another glass of that carrot juice first.
Why not? Encore.
Psst.
Down the hatchway.
Down the hatchway. I gotta find out where they sell this carrot juice. I'm beginning to develop a liking for this vegetable byproduct. Okay, Bella Yukon, pucker up. This is it.
Ready.
How was that?
Another.
What?
Kiss me again, you fool.
No, Bella Yukon, I fear that cannot be. I don't think I should have kissed you at all. However, I had no wish to be ungentlemanly. But another kiss? Nay, I fear not. Impossible.
Stop kissing me! Stop touching me! Stop kissing me! You mean stop kissing me!
Huh?
Don't touch me! Stop kissing me! No, 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 don't kiss me! Stop kissing me!
I'm not kissing you.
That's what you think.
I heard a woman scream.
That's me.
I mean before. A scandal in the old Teller house.
Jack!
Shocking. Poor Miss Mockingbird. Your fiancé is nothing but a bohemian. I suspected as much. This fellow has no shame.
What's all the commotion?
What sort of establishment is this place? This man is a masher.
He drank like a madman, took me in his arms, and kissed me.
Jack doesn't drink. He promised his mother.
Carrot juice. It was only carrot juice.
Smell that.
Sweet Maddie Lane, surely you don't believe any of this.
I feel dizzy.
I'll tell you one thing. This sure ain't carrot juice. What is it then? Whiskey.
Whiskey?
You broke your bottle.
The cad's a rotter! Or the rotter's a cad, whichever you prefer.
Wait, it's all a mistake. It's all some horrible mistake.
Yes, and you made it. Look upon this ugly scene as a blessing, Miss Mockingbird. He has revealed his true colors. I shudder to think of your life, married to this drunken fiend.
Fiend?
A man who would break a promise to his mom would stop at nothing.
Remember this, Jack Goodhart. Mom spelled backwards is... Mom.
You promised me you would never kiss another girl. And I saw you kissing Bella Yukon.
I wasn't kissing her. She was kissing me. Besides, Bella Yukon isn't a girl.
She's a woman.
And how?
You never kissed Bella Yukon?
Well, I
Maybe, that is, you know, once.
There you have it, Miss Mockingbird. The truth from his own liquor-soaked lips.
What is this craving I have? It's a new sensation. I thirst as I have never thirsted before.
Drunkard!
Who? Where?
My heart is broken. And I lament it. How soon can we leave, Mr. Rodent?
My buggy awaits.
I shall never give my love to another man. From now on, I'm wedded to the stage.
Wait, sweet Madeline!
I'll tell the boys it's all right you're leaving town.
Do. Next stop, the Metropolitan Opera! Oh, that's what she thinks.
At least there's comfort in the bottle. No, no, I won't give her up. I love sweet Maddie Lane, and she loves me. If Roderick Roden tries to interfere, he will rue the day, this I swear. But first, one more little sip.
Not easy being a cowboy. My grandfather was a cowboy, my father was a cowboy, now I'm a cowboy. No, it's not easy being a cowboy, because everybody you go and people start saying, boo, And so I walk into this bar, in this corner, this guy in the corner says, "Moo!" And being in a bad mood and all, I said, "Haven't I seen your face on the sheriff's wall?" He didn't answer. I said, "Aren't you Billy the Kid?" "Yeah," he said. I said, "You kind of look like a goat." He said, "You got a problem with that?" "No, no, not me, but your wife might." Well, Billy the Kid's notorious for being a fast draw. But let me tell you, I was in the next town before he moved his hand. I ran so fast it took my horse a week to catch up. Well, in this next town, I was trying to find a job, and well, the hotel I was staying at was getting mad because I missed the last three payments, and so I had to go to my last resort, betting. So I struck up a deal with this guy that while I was on my horse, I could jump over a standing man. Well, we put 10 bucks on it, and after he paid me, there I was. I could see him in the distance. The dust blurred my vision. Starting to perspire. There he was. We were coming closer. Displayed before me. We were upon him. We ran through him, and on it was to the next town. Well, this next town, the 10 bucks went kind of quick, especially after being held at gunpoint twice, and so I had to display my talents at a local bar. It went a little something like this. "Don't give me a home, where the banks will not loan, and the poison and the antidote play. But the stars up above, all the girls are in love, and the cowboys around here crochet." And on it was to the next town. Well, this new town consisted mostly of rich folk, and me only having $3 to my name couldn't survive with its high prices. So off to the side of the road, I put up this sign saying, "Beautiful pictures drawn here." And what do you know? This gallant rich woman approaches me and wants me to draw her picture. "Well, say, since you're such a pretty little thing, I'll paint your picture for a mere 15 bucks. You know, she believed me. Well, I had my papers policy, and after I had the money in my pocket, the drawing got underway. Well, 30 minutes later, I presented it to her with a confident smile on my face. Well, her face went dark, and she let out a shriek that would put Sitting Bull into convulsions. I mean, I didn't see the big problem. Besides her head being enormous and one leg being longer than the other, I didn't see the big deal. Well, she grabbed her husband, and he grabbed his shotgun, and on it was the next town. Well, here I am, trying to get yet a few more bucks, and, not yet accustomed to y'all, I thought I might ask you a few questions. And first off, howdy boys. Not it was to the next town.
She doesn't get any worse. She can't. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
How are ticket sales going?
It'll be a sellout for Maddie Lane's recital.
I hope you know what you're doing. Madeline Mockingbird sings. What's going to happen when people hear that voice?
You see the poster? No refunds.
I put off this debut for as long as I could. Tonight, Maddie Lane will sing, and she will flop. I will console her and tell her that she still needs more training and guidance. I will supply both.
And in return, she will sign this place over to you.
You catch on quick.
I know you so well. What if she refuses?
I'll catch her in a weak moment, which is most of the time.
Since ticket sales are going so well, I'm sure you won't mind if I take a little advance on what's owed me.
You must learn to be patient, Bella. All or nothing.
What's this?
One way to find out.
Paul?
Will the lady who left her dentures in the pot room please speak to an usher?
Do you recognize the handwriting?
No, it's typewritten.
Sounds like that has-been yodeler I've heard from Maddie Lane.
Dave Swan song?
Yeah, she's a lousy music teacher, but she works cheap.
Fiasco! Said that you will be a fiasco! You must cancel the performance!
Cancel it?
Are you senile?
Maddie Lane Mockingbird cannot sing. Her voice is stuck between her face and her chin. And I can't get it out.
Push.
Pull.
To think that I, Madame Sidney Swansong, was once the toast of the upper world.
Toast? More like cracker. Better make that croaker.
Take down that poster!
I'll give you my answer in two words. Never.
You know what they say, Madame Swansong.
Fine.
The show must go on.
Why?
Because I sold $500 worth of tickets, and I don't want to give my money back. I know what's the matter. You want your salary.
It is customary to be paid for one's services.
Well, there you are.
This check is like all the others, drawn on the Bank of Peking.
What's the matter? You got something against the Pekingese. I'm not returning my money.
It is none of my concern if you return the money or not. I will not have my name associated with tonight's performance, and I will not present Madalena Mockingbird to the music lovers of Denver.
Oh, yes, you will.
Won't?
Will?
But!
Will?
But!
Will!
You can't make me.
You get in there and do your job, or I'll...
Oh!
You won't get paid anything more.
See, the Swan Song works only for art.
Art who?
This is what I think of your money.
Mine, because I'm a guy.
Are you done?
Just get on with it.
I'm leaving. No power on earth can turn a Madalena Mockingbird into a songbird. What are you doing?
Do something, Patrick.
Get back here, you.
Die!
Oh, she's getting away!
No one gets past Roderick Ronan.
Get out of my way! You son of a madness!
The last female who crossed swords with Roderick Ronan hasn't been seen in years.
This is an outrage!
You certainly are. On God.
Stop it!
Maddie Lane ready for tonight, and tonight you will introduce her.
I will not.
Don't push your luck, girlie.
Girlie, that's no way to talk to an
Let her have it, Roderick.
Get in there and do as I say, or swan song will be dead duck.
Touché.
Gee, what a man. You sure told her off, didn't you?
I know how to handle women. You're all putty in the hands of Roderick Rodent. I'll try to make sure she doesn't run out the back way.
You can't trust music teachers.
The cash box. Dare I? Durst I? I durst.
Mustn't put temptation in your path.
I hate you. I've waited years for my money and he hasn't given me back a penny.
Well, I'll be a lump of fool's gold. Look who's here, Herbie.
Howdy, Bella.
Herbie, Chick, what are you two boys doing here?
Maddie Lane's singing tonight, ain't she?
Depends on what you consider singing.
Most of Central City will be here tonight. We don't want to miss her at the booty. Hey, Chick, look at this place.
Well, what do you know? The new Taylor House in Denver looks like the old Taylor House in Central City.
Madeline insisted. Seems she was getting a little homesick. But as you can see, this place is far more lavish. That's genuine candelabra.
All the way from Canada.
He was stupid in Central City. Now he's stupid here in Denver.
You still dealing cards, Bella?
Now and then. A girl has to eat, or in my case, shuffle.
Now me and Herbie have to get some tickets for tonight. Then maybe we can play a hand.
Well, Roderick Rhodes is in charge of ticket sales. No refund.
What's a refund?
It's when you find something to watch.
Afternoon, Miss Yukon.
Judge Fleesome, what are you doing here?
I was wondering if I might speak to Miss Mockingbird.
That won't be easy, Judge.
Oh?
She's getting ready for tonight's performance, and she's terribly nervous.
Oh, yes. Artistic temperament and all that.
Yeah, I guess.
Perhaps tomorrow would be a better time.
Perhaps.
I must admit, Miss Yukon,
you're a dashingly handsome woman.
A pleasant addition to the Denver scene.
Why, Judge Fleesome?
Some evening, would you sup with me?
To what?
Sup, dine, partake of nocturnal nutrition.
Swan song belongs in a birdcage. Ah, just the man I was hoping to see.
Do you mean me?
No, the other guy. Get in there and keep an eye on that music teacher. Be careful, she's tricky.
Check.
No checks, cash only. A joke on my part, Judge. I'm a witty fellow at times.
Ha.
Move it.
I wanted to speak to Miss Mockingbird, but I understand she's all nerves.
If I sing like she does, I'd be nervous too. What do you wish to see her about? I handle all of her affairs.
I'm afraid she spent her entire fortune on this hotel. Consequently, there is no more ready cash.
No more ready cash? That is hard news. Tell me, Judge, I take it you perform marriages?
Why, yes, indeed.
And you're attending Maddie Lane's recital?
I wouldn't miss it for anything. I understand the mayor is going to give her the key to the city.
In Maddie Lane's case, they should make it the off-key.
I'll be on my way.
Stick around after the performance. Might have some business to throw your way.
Certainly. And do give my best to Miss Mockingbird.
Yeah, whatever. I'll get money out of this hotel one way or another.
Ah!
purses. It's a dancing desert dish.
You ran out on me!
Nonsense! I've been working in your interest night and day.
Liar!
Why are women always saying that to me? Fatima, we really should... Fatima! Get it! It's sort of a gentle childish shit on us taking it to the fight!
City, I followed. I have been here in Denver for as long as you. I knew what you thought of me, so I had no wish to intrude on your new life. You see, dear Maddie Lane, I have come to my senses. We are now both mature people, and I am here for only one reason, to wish you heaps of success.
Heaps of what?
Success, heaps of success.
That's what I thought you said. You're no longer addicted to the bottle's lure?
The bottle's what?
Lure.
That's what I thought you said. I don't drink anymore, but I don't drink any less. I imagine fellow Yukon continues to denounce me, and I know defending myself would be pointless. These are for you.
What are they?
They're flowers.
I feel something for him. I cannot deny that. But I, a modern young woman, my career comes first.
She is still beautiful and everything I desire in a girl. Oh, fate, you have played a cruel, cruel trick.
Things are going well with you, Jack?
I'm considered a success, yes.
No longer a semi-success?
That is so.
I am happy for you.
I'm told that you own this hotel.
True.
That Roderick Rodent manages all your affairs.
He's my business manager and advisor. Nothing more.
I don't like the fellow.
Are you attending my debut?
Wild horses couldn't keep me away, Maddie Lane. You see, I have developed a stable mind. Sorry.
Then we shall be good friends, Jack.
Alas, success has made us both cautious with our emotions.
My heart trembles at this reunion.
Might I give you a good luck kiss?
For old time's sake.
Am I too greedy?
I must not excite myself. I must rest my vocal cords. Men of Swan Song says they're tired. Thank you for your good wishes. You are looking well. I must exit before my tears betray me. This meeting has revealed a wondrous...
I will not say goodbye, Betty Lane. I will only say... So we meet again.
Treacherous female.
Roderick Rodent.
That's Miss...
Do you mind?
That's Mr. Rodent to you. I wouldn't advise hanging about the lobby.
Indeed.
If you persist, I shall call the house detective.
I'm sorry, I've always wanted to say this. Go ahead, make my day. And Maddie Lane Mockingbird's manager and advisor to boot.
You keep talking, painter, and it'll be my boot you'll be getting.
I warn you, if any harm should come to sweet Maddie Lane,
you'll do what?
Harm her and you shall discover my wrath.
Your what?
I'm wrath, fury, anger, retribution.
You're talking gibberish.
I'm talking American.
Get out.
Gladly.
But first?
What?
I should like a ticket for tonight's performance.
I'd like to help him out. Which way did he come in?
I'll pay cash, of course.
A cash customer, that's a little different. Huh? Business is business.
How much is the ticket?
How much have you got there?
$50.
What a coincidence! Tickets are $50 a piece.
Enjoy the recital. It'll be a night to remember.
And then some.
Good afternoon to you, Roderick Rodent.
Good afternoon to you, Jack Talouse Goodheart. Have no talent. So what?
This is all so
been under pain.
And Maddie Lane's been under rehearsed. You broke even. Calamity, put the complaints and get over there and do as I told you.
I don't like this, Mother.
This is culture. It's good for you.
So is spinach. I don't like that either.
Always remember, dear, you're not supposed to like culture. You're supposed to appreciate it. There's a big difference.
Ladies and gentlemen, music lovers, permit me to introduce myself. I am Madame Dida Swanson, retired.
What'd she say, Chick?
She said she's tired.
This is my
pleasure.
No, that's not it.
Yes,
you want me to say that? Okay, it is my pleasure to introduce to you a woman with very unusual vocal
accomplishment.
Accomplishment. And now, without further ado,
what does that mean? Ado?
It's what you say at a wedding. Do about nothing.
And now, without further ado, the one, the only, it is to be hoped, Madeline Mockingbird.
No problem, ladies and gentlemen. Just a little touch of stage fright. Let's show Madeline she doesn't have to be afraid.
There it is, culture. I saw her first.
Sing the ears off in our heads.
How rude.
I knew her when she wore an apron.
But you insisted.
I insisted?
She admits it.
I told you she wasn't ready for a debut. She needed more time for study. But oh no, you had to have it your way.
In the grape! I washed my hands of this entire affair.
If your hands got dirty, they got that way from stealing money.
Stealing money?
Taking money under false pretenses. Singing lessons, you should be arrested for fraud.
I must be going mad.
No, it's I who's going mad.
Leave this place and never again darken its porch.
This place doesn't have a porch.
And besides, none of us are perfect. I mean, I'm really close, but perfect, that's ridiculous.
They didn't like me. That wasn't an audience. It was a jury.
More like a posse. Listen to me, Maddie Lane. You debutanted too soon. Here's what we'll do.
What?
First, we'll sell the hotel. Then, we'll travel to all the great cities of the world. Rome, Paris, London. Here's a park. You'll study with the best teachers your money can buy.
We'll debut in front of a much better class of audience.
Won't that be funsy? I'm not getting through. You're signing over the hotel to me. Women don't
know that. Because when I was in Central City, everyone told me the same thing.
Good luck.
No. Don't sign anything over to Roderick Rodent.
This is what I call gratitude.
I don't. Rodent, I want my money.
Shh. Oh. Make everything all right. In that case, I offer to you a love that cannot be bought, begged, borrowed, or stolen. So I lie a little. Marry me?
What?
Marry me?
You're demented.
You mean you won't marry him?
No! No! A thousand times no!
You won't marry me?
Moonlight Bridge in the moonlight. It's a dollar a quart.
Ooh, that's a bit... No charge.
What?
This is the best gag in the whole show. How's she look?
Is Miss Maddie Lane finished with her singing?
That's my guess.
I found your performance, interesting, Miss Mockingbird.
Why, thank you, Judge Fleasa.
Dear me, your voice sounds different.
The strain of singing, a touch of laryngitis.
I understand you want to see me after the performance. How might I be of assistance?
Miss Mockingbird has made me the most happiest of men. She is consigned to be my wife.
Your wife? Is this true, Miss Mockingbird?
Yes, sir.
Marry us.
You mean now?
I mean now.
Now.
There's an extra $5 in it if you make it quick.
I don't know. This is off.
I'll make it 10.
Dilly beloved, we are gathered here to...
I do.
And you, Miss Mockingbird?
I do too.
I now denounce you, man and wife.
Victory. I'd invite you to stay for the reception, Judge. Only there isn't going to be one.
In that case, I shall have to decline.
Here's your money.
Thank you. Oh, Jesus.
Sweet Maddie Lane, you were superb.
You enjoyed her recital?
Yes, but alas, I did not hear it all.
You did.
When she opened her mouth and that first note drifted out into the air, I was overcome by the beauty of it all. I had to be alone. A sensitive artist like myself can only absorb so much beauty at one time. Listen up, Judge. You know how you think I'm cute. Set? Where is she? I must congratulate her. Maddie Lane!
There's no sense in staying for the reception. There isn't going to be one.
Reception? Oh, you mean in honor of sweet Maddie Lane's debut?
No, I mean her marriage.
Marriage? To who? I mean whom? To whom? Whom?
Mr. Roderick Rodin.
Roderick Rodent? No, this cannot be.
Yes, it can. I ought to know. I married them. They are man and wife.
No! Once again, my heart is broken. Once again, fate is cruel.
Fate who?
Once again, Roderick Rodent has defeated me.
I shall leave Denver and join the Foreign Legion, or become a teacher in the Ferndale School District. You're making me blush. What's the matter? We got some teachers out there? Or do you all just live in Ferndale? At any rate, life's not worth living.
That depends on the liver. Poor boy. He's half out of his mind. I must help him.
Liquor only makes me worse, the good heart.
That's what you think.
I hear music. I hear voices. Where am I? Who am I? What's happened? I feel so strange.
Don't you remember?
Remember what?
I proposed marriage, and you congealed.
No!
Yes.
Judge Fleesa married you minutes ago. Too bad your mother and father couldn't attend the ceremony.
I don't have a mother.
Excellent. No mother to misguide her.
I'm an orphan.
Orphans make the best wives. You don't have to support their parents.
No! No! First that awful recital and now this? I must be going mad. Yes, that's it. Mad. Mad, madly mad.
J.P. pushed toward the edge.
Rubbish! Get her an aspirin.
I don't think that's going to help.
Do it!
Going.
Hickory dickory dock. The mouse ran out the clock.
The curfew must not ring tonight.
Come home! Come home! Please, Father dear, come home.
Keep calm, Eddie Lane. Keep calm. Hurry with that aspirin!
It's all an insane dream. Yes, that's it. But what if it's true? Married to a rodent? No! Happiness and success have eluded me. I know. I'll end it all. The river.
You'll feel quite... Maddie Lane! Get back here, you silly girl! There's papers to be signed! Maddie Lane! Married for only 5 minutes, and she's already run out on me.
But still,
she won't accept the net of Roderick Rodent. You again? Have you no respect for your elders?
No!
Exit Roderick Roden. Stage right.
So I stumbled off into the night. Maddie Lane, too, stumbled into the night. I've been stumbling all this time.
Well, I guess that's why folks call dudes like you stumble bum.
You poor man! Can you forgive the way I've acted? Your story is both heart-rendering and tragic!
Pathetic!
Sad, too!
Doesn't make any sense! What do you mean? How come he knows things from the
Various people tried to fill me in on all the minor details. Fatima, Judge Fleesum, they all tried to help me.
I never heard such a miserable story. I thought it was gonna be like Little Red Riding Hood and the Wolf. I can see Maddie Lane now, singing her eyes out.
I can't, and I'm glad.
I shall draw right here a picture of the face that drove me mad. And you shall see the lovely Maddie Lane upon the barroom floor.
Is that sanitary?
The blood is on the set!
Listen!
Maddie Lane!
Maddie Lane!
Rodin!
Rodin!
Maddie Lane Rodin!
Maddie Lane Rodin!
Where is she? I know she's here.
Who?
Don't play games with me, my wife! I tracked her hither and yon. She was spotted on the road to Central City.
You talking about Fleet Maddie Lane?
You know I am.
She ain't here.
She's here.
Checked in.
I should have known.
Welcome back, Maddie Lane.
My dear girl, I heard you sing in Denver.
So did I. I'll never forget it.
I wondered what would come of you.
Thank you, thank you. You're all too kind. I'm underwhelmed.
I have sketched here a portrait of the face that might well buy the soul of any man. I now place one last lock upon the shapely head. And now, with a fearful shriek, I shall fall across the picture, dead. Shriek!
Something deep down inside of me drew me back to Central City.
What was that?
Instinct.
What'd she say, Herbie?
She said the place still stinks.
I am delighted your wits have been restored. I miss my little nightingale.
You?
You'll sign here, my dear?
What is she signing?
I see no reason why I shouldn't tell you. As a legal husband, I have a right to every square inch of her property.
Here, Grandmother.
I'm an impatient man. My wife wishes to get out of her career.
I don't want a career anymore. I want a home and children with the man I love. But rejected.
Fine.
Don't you put a hand on her.
I might have to put a hand on her, but I sure will put a big lump on you.
No violence, please. If I sign, will you get out of my life? Will you leave me alone?
It's a deal.
It's a promise.
Would I lie?
I'll sign.
Wait!
Someone's coming in.
This place gets more traffic than a free lunch counter.
Don't sign!
Why, it sounds like Billy, you...
I have come to the aid of this poor girl.
I don't believe my ears.
I'm married now.
Married?
Respectable.
Respectable? You? I chuckle.
I have told my husband everything, and he stands behind me.
I'd like to stand behind her and push.
Who do you marry, Bella?
My husband.
You're Mrs. Judge Fleesum?
I am.
You're in society now.
Bah! This looks mad. My wife has told me everything.
You mean
Everything?
You're not married to Roderick Roden, sweet Madeleine.
I'm not?
The marriage was faked. I ought to know. I was there.
A marriage that never was.
Lies! All lies! They're lying. What do you have to say for yourself?
Give me back my $10.
I'm preferring criminal charges against you.
On account of the marriage that wasn't one?
No, for passing bad checks.
Bad checks?
I have never passed a bad check in my entire lifetime.
Hypocrite!
Who's that?
It's that woman who said she was tired.
Every one of this man's checks bounced higher than a kangaroo. Bank of Peking indeed.
Madam Swansong! Then I don't have to sell my hotel? And I'm not married to him?
You can wipe away Roderick Roden like dust from a tabletop.
Dust?
I've got the old teller house, and Maddie Lane has the new one!
Wait!
Someone else is coming in!
Who? Shit!
You can stop the bells now, darling. I am...
Yes?
Miss Bonaparte B. Boogaloo.
Boogaloo?
How do you spell it? Years ago, my husband deserted me. Then I heard he struck it rich, that he left a fortune to a sweetheart.
She means you, Madeleine.
Never Bonaparte be Boogaloo's sweetheart.
I had to find out for myself. I believe you.
Thank you, strange person.
But the hotel is mine. I'm the legal heir to the Boogaloo fortune, and I claim it.
She can do what she says, Maddie Lane. The law's on her side.
You mean I'm penniless?
Nickelless, quarterless, and dollarless, too.
Tell you what, Maddie Lane, you can sing here during the tourist season.
Huh?
Folks need a good laugh now and then.
But what do I do the rest of the year?
I save your mop and pail.
Yeah! I've had enough! Enough, 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 enough! I've been insulted! I've been ignored. I've been humidified. I just have one thing to say.
What?
How about a nice hand for the piano player?
Oh, good job. Oh!
man. He shall now buy me victory.
Central City to ask you about it, you can tell them the story of
the face on the barroom floor.
Rats!
For getting that standing ovation started. Now, before you leave, there are a few people we'd like to thank.
Come on!
We read that last time.
That was funny last time. I don't know if it'll be funny tonight.
We'd like to thank our stage manager, Paul Letissier.
We'd like to thank Angela Burnham, Julie Schmidtel, and all the adults who helped on costumes. We'd like to thank Gabriel Bukowski and Rachel Pester for sound. We'd like to thank Tim Evers and Matt Kelleher for lights. And we'd like to thank a couple of madmen who were a driving force behind all this. First of all, our student producer, Mr. Eric S.F. Willard.
Come on!
We'd like to thank our student director, Mr. David Archimedes Keylock Dawkins Gill.
Yeah.
The piano player is Scott Rodula. And then, of course, we'd like to thank Miss Merley, because she did all of this, and she doesn't get a lot of thanks, so please.
Because without you, we'd look really stupid up here.